literally no wind today. It's so peaceful. The sound of the birds, too. Not the cars, but the birds. It is a tiny smallmouth. You fell right off. Okay. Hold on. Good to get action in the first 10 minutes. It's a form of good luck if I put the first fish in the bucket. Happy 4th of July. Feels pretty good. I'm going for a catfish. And it is a catfish. It is a catfish. Yeah. Oh, yes. Not a biggie, but I was targeting catfish with a drop shot. I'm at a hole that's pretty deep, about 30 feet deep. Yeah, I got it. So what I've been using is a bell weight. This is probably half an ounce. Any more than 16 inches is good. Keep it that far off the bottom. I used a half of a nightcrawler rubber worm. This is one of those swivel type of drop shot hooks, so it can go around the line. See the way they point out like that? If you stab yourself, it's gonna smart for a while. Look at that. You gonna say something? I'll put you in the bucket for a moment. With your friend, Mr. Smalley. Can I catch one of your bigger brothers? A giant whisker. Helps them see under the darkness of this water. Yeah. That's the perfect way to hold it. Right behind the spikes. Okay. If you drag your drop shot a little bit, this will be the tail end. And hopefully, most of the time, the fish will grab it from the tail end, and then they can get to the hook. I just felt something. Yes, something's interesting. It felt like a catfish also. I kind of do that one bite and one tug. Yeah, as I was saying, try not to move the drop shot too much. You can sort of troll it. Oh, there it is. Make sure it's got it in its mouth. Yeah. Oh, good. Good. Tight lines, man. Oh. It's a small one. You have to be more careful with these tiny guys because their spikes are even sharper than the adults, and the young ones have these freckles, these little freckles on their body, possibly for camouflage. I'm casting not in a hole this time, but near a fallen tree, 12 to 15 feet here. Of course, you can use real night crawlers, which I use also, if you can keep them on the hook and they don't steal it. I'm feeling some bites on this one. It's probably another small one. Yeah, something is experimenting with the worm. You can jig it a little bit, but not too much. Just enough to give it some movement, some action. All fish like that. Yeah. Oh. Yeah. What is this? This doesn't quite feel like a catfish. Oh, I think it's a bass. Oh no! I was fooled. A young, spry catfish. Wow. He was moving just like a smallmouth. Ah, that was easy. Not too bad. Trying to get the line off. Don't stab me! All this residue on the surface of the water, it's just standing water, kinda. Thank you. I think this is a really good spot. Catfish hang out in good cover, and a fallen tree is good cover. Yeah, I feel bite already. Yeah, he's going for it. Just run with it, will you? He probably took it. Oh, wait. There's pressure. There's pressure, yeah. Yeah. It's coming up. Coming up. That's good. Good strength on this one. It is another catfish, yes! Come on, come to the party. Come to the party. Yeah! It's actually in the soft of his left cheek. He is bigger. You can always tell by... Oh, hold on. Thanks. And it's kind of a humid day, very hot. I toss into a cove that is shaded, and these guys like to hide in there too. I got you. Oh, you're a biter. You're a biter. Okay. Yucky. Yes, you're bigger. I felt your stronger fight. 16 inches. Dark green, up to silver and white. Pretty little channel catfish.
Ooh, belly.
Nice and shallow here. Good place to step out for a second. My morning. We'll be out on the water. Then get back for lunch. And I hope you're having a great Independence Day. Well, USA, thanks for watching my video, everybody. We'll be catching catfish on a drop shot rig. It's sad to see people treat their canoe that way. Be good to your canoe, and your canoe will be good to you.